Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu was martyred when he was approximately 63 years old, the 40th year of Hijrah, by a man known as Abdurrahman ibn Muljim.
How it all began is that there were three of the Khawarij and discussing the affairs of the Ummah. One of them said, all of the problems we have today are because of Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. The other said, all of the problems we have today are because of Ali radiallahu anhu. And the third one said, Amr ibn al-As is not far from those two either. So they decided right then and there to get rid of these three. And so they agreed to kill all three of them at the same time. Of course, all three were in different areas. But they agreed that after Fajr prayer on the 17th of Ramadan, so all of them left to these different cities, a man by the name of Al-Burq ibn Abdullah al-Tamimi, he goes to Al-Sham to kill Muawiyah. And he prays Fajr behind him. And as Muawiyah left the masjid after the salah, he lifted his sword to strike Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. Muawiyah noticed that. He caught the sword going up and he jumped out of the way. So he got cut, but it didn't kill him. Then the other man, the man goes to Amr ibn al-As, the second man. And after the salah, he jumped and started to stab him. And he killed him and said, Allahu Akbar. And then he discovers that Amr ibn al-As, قدر الله, he was sick that day, so he actually killed the wrong man. The man who went to Ali radiallahu anhu, his name was Abdurrahman ibn Muljim. And this man, he came to Al-Kufa, where Ali radiallahu anhu was. And he found Ali radiallahu anhu coming into the masjid, calling the people for salah. Ayyuhal nas, as-salah, as-salah. And so, this is before the salah. Ibn Muljim takes his weapon, and he attacks Ali, saying, Al-Hukm lillah. The judgment is to Allah, not to you, O Ali, nor to your companions. He struck Ali radiallahu anhu in his forehead. And it was a huge wound, and the sword was poisoned. But Ali radiallahu anhu doesn't die immediately. He stays alive for 3 days. Don't let him get away. So they caught the man. A man by the name of Jundub ibn Abdullah, he enters and he says, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, if we lose you, and I hope we don't, should we pledge to Al-Hasan? And Ali radiallahu anhu says, I do not order you, nor do I prevent you. So then he calls Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn, and he starts to give them very, very beautiful advice. These are now his parting words. So he tells them, I advise you with the taqwa of Allah. And then he tells Al-Hasan, if I die, whoever struck me this blow, then it's a blow for a blow. And do not desire the dunya, even if it calls you to it. And do not cry over something that gets away from you, and speak the truth. And have mercy on the orphan. He says, assist the lost, and work for the next life. And be the opponent of the oppressor, and the supporter of the oppressed, and act on what is in the book of Allah, and do not fear those who will blame you for doing what is right. Then he turns to his other son, Muhammad ibn Hanafiyyah, and he tells him, have you learned what I advise your brothers with? He says, yes, it means it applies to you as well. And then he tells him, I advise you with the same, and I advise you to have respect for your brothers, because of the great rights that they have upon you. It means they are the grandchildren of the Prophet ﷺ, so you have to have respect for that. And do not undertake any affair without them. Then he turns to Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn. He says, I advise you to take care of him. For he is your brother and the son of your father. And you know that your father used to love him. Then he tells Al-Hasan, he tells him, O son, I advise you with the taqwa of Allah and establishing salah and paying the zakah in its place and perfecting the wudu. And I advise you to forgive others and to control your temper and the ties of the wombs and clemency with the ignorant and understanding of the religion and being conclusive in affairs, meaning don't rush to make decisions, and being close to the Quran and being good to your neighbor and commanding that which is good and forbidding that which is evil and abstaining from the haram. And he keeps on advising them and advising them until he passed away radiallahu anhu.